Okay, this is a centrifuge. And we use this during the lab final to separate your precipitate and the solution that it is mixed with. So basically, how you do this is you have two different types of test tubes, or centrifuge test tubes. One of them will just be not labeled, it's just a clear glass tube. You use that to mix your solutions together. So what you can do is take your first solution, put it in the tube, distill it with a little bit of water, and then put in your other solution that's going to cause the precipitate to form. Okay, and then distill that with a little bit more water, and you're going to be left with a solution with the precipitate in the tube. And then you take these other tubes that have a C on them, and that's just for the balancing process. And what that means is you have to distill that with, or just fill it up with distilled water, approximately to the same height to where the clear tube was, or to where that came up to, so it balances out the mass. So when you put them in this centrifuge over here, you want to make sure they're exactly apart from each other, like right across from each other, because that'll help balance out the centrifuge, and it won't shake as much and it'll run smoothly. Over here, after you're done with that, you're going to have a precipitate either on the bottom or the side of your tube, and the solution is going to be separated from it. So you take that, and then you take this little barrel pipette, and you extract the supernatant liquid, which is basically the liquid that separated from the precipitate when you did the centrifuging process. You extract that and just put it into another test tube just to hold, and after every centrifuge process, you want to make sure that you have a little beaker of distilled water just to rinse your pipette out with. And each centrifuge is different. We have two different kinds. This one is a little bit older style, and it has a speed knob. So you just want to make sure that speed's all the way up, and it has a little timer over here, which is, that's how you start it. You switch the timer to whatever increment minute you want, which we have a little stopwatch here, which that makes it easier because we're only going to be going for like 3 minutes, and this goes up to like, it goes in increments by like 5, and it just kind of gets confusing. It'd be hard to track. And the other one, it's more digital. It has a start-stop button, and so that's pretty much it.